Om Sri Sai Ram. Prasanthi Sandesh welcomes you. Today I would like to share with you unforgettable experiences of three imminent, popular, ardent devotees of Bhagavan Baba. The first and foremost is Anjali Devi, a film actress from South India. She acted in hundreds of films in different languages of South India: Telugu, Tamil, Kannada, so on and so forth. She received many state and national awards. She is really a long-standing devotee of Bhagavan. Swami used to visit her residence whenever he happened to go to Madras. Most of you must be knowing, just by the side of her residence at Madras, there is vast land, and that belongs to her. She donated the whole site to Sri Sai Tamil Nadu Trust. And there they built a very, very beautiful mandir, Sundaram, the Swami's building, temple, Sundaram. Sundaram means beauty. Really speaking, it is a befitting name given to that building. Name is given by Bhagavan, Sundaram, very beautiful. It's so beautiful that upstairs we find a projection like a lotus flower so that Swami can stand there and give Darshan, as here in Prasanthi Nilayam, that lotus flower in front of the silver gate on the top here in Prasanthi Nilayam. Like that, Swami can come out and stand there upstairs building near the lotus flower and give darshan. I am a witness to that wonderful scene. Madras consists of many, many devotees. No surprise that thousands attend Nagar Sankirtan, particularly when Swami happens to be there. When these thousands of devotees assemble there, all lights are projected on Swami upstairs. And down, where all we sit on the ground, is all dark. It's just Nagar Sankirtan time, twilight. It's dark still. Lights are focused on Swami, standing on the lotus flower. What a beautiful heavenly sight it is. I don't think it's possible for any poet to describe and do justice to the entire scene. That's what Sundaram is. And be that as it may, the whole land is donated by Anjali Devi. Well, Swami, when he was in Kodaikanal, mentioned one incident relating to Anjali Devi that I want to share with you. I tell you what Swami said, that's all. She might have had many, many miracles, but I do not know them. But the one I am going to tell you is narrated by Bhagavan himself in Kodaikanal. In those days, late 50s or early 60s, Anjali Devi produced a film, a cinema, by name Suvarna Sundari. Suvarna Sundari. Her husband Adinarayan Rao is a music director. And this cinema, Suvarna Sundari, fetched them 1 crore rupees profit in those days, 1960s. 60s, you can imagine what it is. It's not a small amount. In those days, I tell you. Well, she took Swami's blessings, and with that blessings only, that film was released. See how time acts. As years gone by, they produced another cinema. They sustained heavy loss. They could not face the public. Both of them, husband and wife, drove to Mahabalipuram, a seashore near Madras. Mahabalipuram is a place that many people visit, which is of historical importance. Many visitors go there. There's sea close by. Husband and wife went to Mahabalipuram straight, driving. Well, they drove and they wanted to go into the sea straight away. Drive the car into the sea. In other words, they wanted to commit suicide. Will Baba allow such a thing to happen? When they were about to get into the sea, they heard a loud shout. Stop! Stop! Come back! They got down and saw on both sides. They didn't find anybody. They sat again and wanted to commit suicide by driving the car straight into the sea. Again louder shout. Stop, come back. Then they could understand Swami wants them in Puttaparthi. They dropped their attempt to commit suicide and drove straight to Puttaparthi. And Baba consoled them. Why are you afraid? Am I not here? Do I allow you to die like that? That's what Swami said. This miracle of Anjali Devi is narrated by Bhagavan himself. I'm so glad to share with you this wonderful experience of Anjali Devi. Then there is another cinema actor, by name Kantarao, K-A-N-T-H-A, Kantarao, a popular actor and a very great devotee of Bhagavan. This actor is very famous, in fiction stories, mythological stories, story-based films. Mythological story-based films and fiction like that. And he is known to fight, and he can fight with swords, archery, and also he knows horse riding. Therefore, he was very much involved in such scenes where he can exhibit his talents. There is one director in those days by name Vithalacharya. In all his films, most necessarily, Kantarao is the hero. And this Kantarao, the film hero, happened to visit a place by name Sullurpet in Nellur district of Andhra Pradesh. Kantarao and I shared the same platform. When Kantarao spoke at that meeting, I'm directly telling you what he shared his experience with a large gathering that evening. Kantarao said, Swami helped me in many ways. Not only blessings, he was of financial help to me also. That's what Kantarao said. It seems in one of the film shootings, he was to fight with an enemy with swords. Swords, tuck, tuck, they should fight. And suddenly he was supposed to jump from one boat to another, into another boat. There are two boats. He will be fighting, standing posture, while he was there in a boat, and suddenly has to jump into another boat. Whole thing is sea, vast sea. Two boats are there. One, he was fighting, and he should jump into another boat. Fighting was going on with swords. Now it was time for him to jump into another boat. Kantharao jumped. Instead of getting into another boat, he fell in the middle. He fell in the middle, deep water, water there, sea water. He would have drowned and died then and there itself. But Kantharao explained at the public meeting. Two hands lifted him up, and the two hands did not allow him to drown. He was brought to the boats safe and secure. The two powerful hands lifted the whole body and placed me in another boat. And these two hands are none other than Bhagavan Sri Sai Baba. Later when he visited Prasanthi Nilayam, Swami said, "You are fighting very good. You should also know the distance between the two boats and then fight, so that you can easily jump into the other. But you fell in the middle. You would have died. Had I not been there, what would have happened to you by now?" And Swami said. This miracle Kantharao narrated on the dais. He also shared another experience. He got his daughter married, and she was to join her in-laws. The day when she was to leave Madras, Kantharao had film shooting there. He was very busy with the shooting of the film. He could not accompany his daughter. So he asked his wife to accompany the daughter and drop her there in her in-law's house, right? In strict obedience to her husband, wife of Kantharao accompanied the daughter with all the boxes and the jewels. Most unfortunately, by the time they reached their destination, to their utter surprise, they found the jewels bundle, the bundle of jewels, missing, totally gone. Someone must have stolen the whole lot. What to do? She immediately rang up to Kantharao and said that they lost the jewels. She was reprimanding her husband for not joining them. And in turn, Kantharao was also scolding wife why she was reckless. Later, after a heated argument on phone, his wife and daughter returned to Bangalore. In the meantime, Kantharao also reached Bangalore. They were all sitting there for Swami's darshan. Swami slowly and slowly came towards Kantharao. Kantharao was seated in the fourth row, but he had no chance to touch the feet of Swami. Therefore, what he did was, he jumped from fourth row, right fell at the feet of Swami. Swami scolded him before everybody. "Do you think this cinema shooting? Is it not indisciplined to jump like that?" Scolded them. And later, he called the couple and granted them interview. There in the interview room, the couple cried and said what happened, that they lost the jewels. Swami heard patiently and waved his hand. By the wave of his hand, he brought the bundle of jewels they lost. They lost somewhere at a remote distance. And Swami materializes the bundle of jewels here and then asks Kantarao's wife, please open the bundle, verify whether jewels belong to you or not. She will, Swami, they are our jewels. Good, take it, be happy. Our Swami could materialize jewels, lost jewels, in perfect state. That is Bhagavan, how he blessed Kantarao. So, in this episode, we could hear two eminent, prominent, popular devotees, film actors Anjali Devi and Kantarao, meet again next time.